We're also turning to biodiesel to help beat these outrageous gas prices, but not everyone's doing it legally. News 5's Brian Hamrick is here now with the growing number of grease bandits and how some are making a slick getaway with the stolen goods. Brian?
Well, there's a strange connection between high gas prices and a string of bizarre thefts, of all places, at dumpsters that contain something as good as gold, even better, as good as gas.
It's the last place you might expect a theft. But this is a growing target for high-dollar dumpster divers trying to, of all things, beat high gas prices.
With the increased attention of biodiesel and alternative fuels, we have seen an increase in grease theft.
Chris Griffin is with Griffin Industries. They're the victims. They make, among other things, biodiesel out of used cooking oil or yellow grease collected here at restaurants.
We operate in about 20 states, and I'd say we deal with about 4 to 5 reports of theft a day.
The thefts coincide with an increase in vehicles converted to use cooking oil. In fact, they become so commonplace. Watch this.
He's developed his own unique method of oil acquisition.
During an Arkansas TV news report on converted vehicles, this guy actually steals the grease on camera.
First thing you do is check your oil.
How do we know? It was Griffin's container.
What that news station had done was actually filmed a gentleman, breaking into Griffin's grease container and stealing the grease.
This guy even had permission from the restaurant, even though it wasn't actually theirs to give away. With gas prices so high, right now, grease is the word.
And that yellow grease is actually traded as a commodity, going for about $2.24 a gallon right now. So you can see why the grease at almost every restaurant is already claimed. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, News 5, where the news comes first.